All right, so let's have a look at the SSD again. So this is the Samsung SSD. That's our that's our board, our memory chips. That's the controller we transferred. So what we'll do, we'll have a look at on the thermal camera, the reaction under this SSD, just to check if it is working, detected, or any activity going on. I've got here a laptop. We're going to use direct to USB, which is fine. Okay, so what we're going to do, make some room here. Just going to yank it in there and have a look on the thermal camera, see what we see. So that's on, and thermal camera. Here we go. And then we'll check the solder balls on the bottom, see if there is anything going on there, if any pins are misaligned or not soldered. We'll have a look. Okay, so that's been reset. We'll keep it there. Here we go. Ready, set, plugged into the computer. Pretty much similar behavior. So we've got the, here we can see that area heating up as normal. This is good. I mean, it should do something now. This is normal temperature. Still no reaction on the computer. What happened? Yeah, no reaction on the computer at all. Okay, let's disconnect. Reconnect. Okay, disconnected fully. Reconnected. It's interesting, before I didn't get them heated up, now I do. I mean, generally it's a good sign that something's happening there. It's definitely getting warm, but not hot. So that there is activity, which is fine. But we're getting nothing. And the device manager. We don't have the destroy. These two are part of this computer. View show hidden devices. So we can see J Micron. That's the SSD. I believe, or previously connected devices. So I'm going to disconnect the Type-C, sorry, the SSD controller. Okay, let's plug it back in. It's in. Nothing. Well, let's check our connection, see if we made a mistake. Let's remove this out of here. Let me see if I can do like this. One second. Yeah, they're definitely squished in there. Let's have a look a little bit more detailed. So this coil and these two inductors were both 0 ohms before. So those two inductors were 0 ohms before. So what's happened to them? Let's see. Microphone has gone down a little bit. That's better. 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2. Okay. We don't need board view. Let's bring. So what do we got on screen? Okay. Let's have a look in resistance mode. To ground will be somewhere on the casing. 1 kilo ohms. Interesting. So that's, well, good in a way. The other one was 2 kilo ohms. Right. So what else? I mean, the only other thing could be, I mean, this guy here, but I have no idea why it will be that. What else could have died when this one died on the other one? Is this a Samsung proprietary part? What is that? How about the other inductors? How are their feelings? Two kilo ohms, I like that. Okay. Okay, 1.8 kilo ohms. Could there be a resistor that failed along with the controller? Maybe. Let's bring the donor assist, donor part. Okay. Okay. So let's check one thing. Right. That's a 10 kilo ohms resistor. Ten kilo-ohms resistor. No short. No short. That's a two or just a blank resistor. Same. 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 Let's continue. We just don't want them, we just want them to have similar reading, that's all. Okay, let's continue. Oh, what was that? Okay. Already checked those two. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. Let's continue. Okay. We just don't want any shorts. That's what I'm looking for with these guys. And then I'll check the resistor values shortly. That's an inductor to ground is 30 kilohms. Here. Kilo-ohms, okay. So 30 to ground, 1 kilo-ohms and 0. Okay, let's check here. Okay. Should be 1 or 2. 1 to ground. That's okay, because we haven't got a component in there in this one. Okay, let's check these guys. 0. 0. So these are all 0 in this one. One kilo ohms, okay. One, so these are, these all should be 0. Okay, they're all 0. One mega ohms. No short. So many of them. .242. That was 1 mega. Yep. .230. Okay, let me check these on the other one. Same, should be 1 mega. Yep, and yeah, that's correct. Let's check here. 1 kilo ohms. Zero, so 1 kilo ohms and 0. zero. What's that? Got a capacitor. 242 and zero. All right, let's continue this one. Had some interruptions. So this is the one we put the new IC, I mean replacement IC. Let's go from here. Nothing. Four point three. So they're all 4.3. How about this last one? Zero. Okay, let's check it on that one. Fine. Wait, let's double check. Zero, okay. /241. Okay. Yeah, these are zero. Zero, okay. They both are zero. /4.6. /10 kilo ohms. /10 kilo ohms. 100 kilo ohms. 100 kilo ohms. Now, could there be a problem with our SSDs? I doubt it. 300. 300. /3.36. Yeah, 300. 300. Okay, that one is different. What's this? 4.4 here. /3.3. That's a big difference. could be because there's no controller on one of them. I don't know. There's a diode there. Let's check the diode out. No voltage drop. So the diode is good. This is a BGA chip too. Can't seem to find any fault. I mean, we transferred the controller over. Resistance mode. So that's good. It's going back to normal, like the way this one was before. Slightly off 2.2 kilo ohms. Well, they go to this guy. What does this guy do? It's in a highly protected area, far out. How am I going to get that chip out? Let me take a screenshot. Okay. All right, I'll end the video here for now. I'll come back later.